everyone, welcome back to our second session all together. How was your break, everyone? Did you enjoy during your break or not? Anyway, I hope that you feel fun during your break. So now let's move to our second session all together. And according to our schedule, you are going to learn by Hangout 4. So you still learn by Unit 9 this weekend. So this weekend today, we focus on the workbook. So please open your workbook on page 70 all together so that you can see what today's lesson, right? So in the workbook. So there are two parts that you are going to learn. The first part is look and write. Look and write here, you have to look at the picture. Here, look at the picture here, and then write the word that describe the picture or match with the picture. And then you can go to B, read and circle. You have to read the sentence carefully in order to circle the correct grammar. So what kinds of grammar or what kinds of forms you use in this sentence? What is the correct form? And then you can circle the correct form all together. All right, class. So now let the teacher give you 10 minutes to complete the answer from A until B. After that, you can check the answer with the teacher. But before you check the answer with the teacher, hopefully that you try your best in order to complete by your own self before you check with me. Because some students, they might skip about the part that haven't have the answer, and then move to the part that have the answer only. After that, they just copy in their notebook or in their textbook and submit to their homeroom teacher. So I hope that all of you guys don't do like this and try your best to copy the answer together. Are you ready? Now let the teacher give you 10 minutes to do it. Let's start. Brilliant, everyone. How you done? All right, so now it's time to check the answer with the teacher. So number one, what picture do you see? What picture is it? All right, so it is the pictures of what? Of rainy, stormy, sunny, chilly, or what? Yeah, this is the pictures of rainy. Next, so what picture is it? Great, this is a picture of playing, or we can say play in the yard. Because the first picture they point to the rain, and the second one they point to Brian, so Brian is playing in the yard, right? All right, let's go to number three. Sorry, number two is not playing in the yard. I got confused with the picture. Number five. So number two should be the picture of sun. Sunny, like you can see the sun. Sunshine, right? All right, so let's go to number three. When you see someone bring something to eat outside, it is a kind of activity of having picnic. All right, so let's go to number four. Now four, like you can see the sky is dark, and you also have lightning and windy and so on. So this is the pictures of stormy weather. Number five, like I mentioned earlier, it should be play in the yard. All right, number six, like you can see about Alex feeling, how does he feel? Yes, he feels chilly. Is mean cold in unpleasant way. It means the kind of weather that you feel cold, like you wanna sick. All right, let's go to number seven. Emma is practicing the guitar, right? So this is a picture of practice the guitar. All right, so number eight, this is the picture of play on the tablet. So who is playing on the tablet, everyone? Is Steven, the dad, right? They're on tablet. All right, so now let's go to point B, check the answer with the teacher all together about the grammar part. Now one, if it's chilly this weekend, he'll play or he's playing in the yard. Based on our form, after present verb, it should be future form, right? So future form, sorry, this one should be L, he'll play. So the correct answer should be he'll play. So he is short form of he will. So he will, short form is he'll, right? He'll, right? He'll play in the yard. Number two, if it'll be, it is simply it'll be or it's sunny this weekend, they'll go on a picnic. So like I mentioned earlier, our form should have only present and future form only for first conditional, right? So here you should choose it, right? It'll be sunny. Number three, if it's rainy this weekend, she practices or she'll practice. So it should be she'll practice. Present plus future form become first conditional. Next, for number four, if it's or it was stormy this weekend, he'll play on his tablet. So if you remember our form, it's easy for you to find the answer. Why? Because our form for the first conditional should be present form plus future form, right? In the short, you can say like this. So it should be it's for the present form plus future form. If it's sunny this weekend, last weekend, I'll go on a picnic. Last weekend is a past, so this weekend is a present form. So it should be this one, right? All right, class, hopefully that you have the same answer with your teacher and also with your own answer, your best, okay? With your best answer, not copy from me at all. After you check with me, if you have any mistake, you also can change the answer. After that, submit to your homeroom teacher. All right, class, for today's lesson is finished. If there's still any question, you can ask your homeroom teacher for more detail. Goodbye, everyone. See you tomorrow and have a nice day.